Croteam is back with the serious business of the Talos Principle 2. Following on from the Talos Principle 1, which was, I think it's fair to say, an unexpected success in some ways.
Yeah, it was interesting back then, you know, because there was no signs of any possible success of games like that. But we still believed in it and went for it, and it turned out to be really good. You know, like, and so it raised expectations for Talos 2, so it took us a long, long time to be kind of brave enough to try to fill in those shoes. So I always thought about the game that it sits on four pillars: the story, the core gameplay, the visuals and audio, for example, right? We need to find some way for the game to be really beautiful. I never doubt that Damian will do his magic again, so audio is covered. With the story and core gameplay, it was a little harder. It took us like almost 5 years of thinking, planning, you know, just doing other stuff. But from time to time, a great idea would pop up from the sky, universe, whatever. And, you know, over time, we build up a solid ground of ideas for the core game mechanics and for the story universe that was, you know, oh, this is really something good, beautiful, has a form, has potential, and so we'll build up with excitement good enough so we can, you know, be brave enough to step into that one.
How did you balance trying to create a worthy sequel that you would be proud of and also keeping the fans of the first game happy?
Oh, if you change too much or change anything, people will complain. If you don't change, people will complain. So it's always difficult to make sequels, right? So that's why we were like really, really careful to make something that would feel as a sequel and still be really new and you know, unique.
When did you start thinking about Talos 2 as a story?
It was around the time we were finishing Talos 1, and then during Road to Gehenna, the DLC, because first of all, we had to make a lot of decisions about where is it all leading, so that just to be able to answer questions inside the game itself. What are the characters trying to accomplish? What is going to happen at the end of this? What is the meaning of all this? And there is actually quite a bit of foreshadowing of Talos 2 already in Talos 1 and in Road to Gehenna, some of which I had forgotten. So when we were making this, I was going back, I was like, how about we do this? And then I was looking at the text and I was like, oh, we already decided to do this back then and I forgot because it's been so long.
Talos 1 was what makes a human being a human being. Talos 2 is what makes a civilization a civilization. What does a civilization owe to the world that it inhabits and to its members?
We want to show a civilization that is at the point where things can go in different directions, and to show that there is hope there, there's possibility there, things can evolve, we ourselves could still solve our problems and build a better world. At the same time, we want to deal with the fact that that's very difficult, and that it's difficult to maintain that faith when a lot of people think that we're a virus and everything we do is terrible, and that there is no hope at all, that fundamentally humans are just bad.
Where do you find your inspirations for the kind of more positive perspective that you want to portray?
Ah, that's hard. I quite like the movie Sunshine. There's Interstellar,
yeah,
which has some of that. And old Star Trek. And there's some writers here and there. Ian Banks has The Culture, which we referenced briefly in the game, where there's this kind of utopian, kind of anarcho-socialist society or something, and that has AIs and things. And you think, yeah, that's a lovely world to live in. I'd like to live in that.
For the first game, we had a lot of the game made before the story came in, and this one was a little bit different. I gave them freedom to go ahead and invent the universe, places, locations, and then we'll fit in as with the rest of the game. That changed a lot. I hardly find words to explain how much I resonate with the feel, and this is really cool. You know, Jonas, Verena, and Tom, and you know, they set up this very nice, warm feeling of the science fiction of the 50s, 60s, like the old books, where you could feel excitement and the beauty of the possibilities of the future.
I wanted the Talos Principle to feel familiar for players who already played the first game. So we kept some mechanics from the first game. I think the ones that we felt were the best. Jammer, connectors for the beams, and pressure plates, cubes and stuff like that, that go well together. And we imagined the new mechanics that go well with those, the old ones. So they are kind of expanding the experience that's already familiar. I concluded the more people we include into making those puzzles, more wider scope of puzzles we will have in the end.
And hopefully just as much player satisfaction.
Of course.
When you design the puzzle, you have to consider every way that puzzle can be solved in. And sometimes you have to leave player a little leeway so he can solve it his own way. And there's those small bits, moments, where you are just like in a puzzle and you realize, oh, I have to take this item, do this, and then you solve the whole puzzle. And that's the fun part. We are trying to make them not as complex. It's mostly about that moment that there is just logical leap that you have to do in a puzzle. Aha moment. Yeah, the eureka moment. We are mostly trying to design in Talos 2 principle puzzles that have a eureka moment instead of then just being a lot of repetition in the puzzles. Yeah.
This is the Croteam puzzle room.
Yeah. This is we have this box here.
Box stacking puzzles. The problem is you pull out the wrong box and it all just.
Nothing works anymore.
Gameplay-wise, it's going to be better than Talos 1. So that's, I think the puzzles are more mature. The old one returned. So we have we didn't have rush to make Talos 1 and then you go straight to Talos 2 and Talos 3. So we kind of have a couple of years to reflect what went good, what went wrong, and then make all the best from Talos 1. So.
The Talos Principle 2 real-life puzzle fight. In the colorful corner, we have level designer Mika. In the wooden corner, we have writer Verena. Ready? Go! We have a winner! Yes!
One thing that is also important that we changed was the difficulty curve. It goes up with each new mechanic. We make a few introductory puzzles, which are obviously simpler, just for people to get the new mechanic. And then we raise the difficulty towards the end of that cluster, and then we finish, and then we lower it again with the new mechanic. You are learning new mechanic, and then it raises again, and then I think that's much easier to play and much more fluid.
We had a lot of puzzles that are way, way hard, harder than they should be. So we removed those and left the ones, the balanced ones. So it wasn't, we had a lot of material to work with, to say the least.
And you keep the hard ones for the DLC,
yes, we keep the hard ones for the DLC. And also, let's say it will be exceptional things to see there.
Oh, ooh, hey. There's nothing artificial about your intelligence. Since the 1990s, Croteam has been working in the Sirius engine. This is the first ever game that Croteam has done in another engine, right?
Yep.
And you decided to go for Unreal Engine. Why did you decide to make that move for this game?
Modern day development is very hard, very complex, and people expect you to perform as well or look as well as the next game. And going after that graphical fidelity is the main reason. But also there are other benefits. Now there's a huge community and a huge pool of knowledge we can draw from. There are colleagues that were driving this from the artist side. So we have very, very good technical artist, Tomislav, that I'd like to mention. He was pushing the features, using the features, finding ways to use them, talking with other people also from Epic. Just insane amount of knowledge and in a very quick time.
We love Sirius Engine, we love aspects of this series editor and stuff so much that we implemented a nice set of tools and improvements to Unreal Engine, to editors and stuff.
Oh, so you can't keep your hands off it. No. You've still got to fiddle with the engine.
A little bit.
Do you think it's allowing you to really just focus on the job of making games?
Yeah, these days I think so. Previously we had to plan to spend and use our resources, you know, good amount of excellent people working on, you know, upgrading technology and trying to catch up and whatnot, invent some new stuff. But now those guys could enjoy making, you know, code for the new games. When you were working on the Talos Principle 1, I remember you saying that it was a very sharp turn in a new direction for you musically. Are you more comfortable with making this genre of music that maybe is very different for you still?
No. No, it's still a very sharp turn, you know. Okay.
Every new project, I try to reinvent the wheel, you know, to do something a little bit differently, because it makes me more engaged. You know, it makes this composing and creative process more fun to me. It just makes me a better composer, I'd say. The story of the Talos 2 is now more grander, you know, it's a bigger game, larger, better game. It has so many things up to 11. The scale went up for Talos 2, and suddenly the music felt too small. For every game that we do, I try to find some equivalent in the gaming world or film, movies, you know, music I listen to. So I listen to so many different soundtracks, you know, I looked at so many games, played a lot of them, you know, just to observe. I mean, it's always Hans Zimmer, you know.
Wow. It's like
Hans,
yeah, it's Hans.
Stop
again, sorry guys.
It's always Hans.
It's always Hans, yeah, but there was a guy called Steven Price. I think he won an Academy Award for the Gravity soundtrack, and that soundtrack blew me away. And so I even introduced guitars.
Not those 7/8 strings.
This is not Serious Sam.
It's not Serious Sam, but those are some, you know, Pink Floyd type of guitars.
Okay,
you know,
lots of big reverbs.
Lots of reverbs and wailing and stuff like that. So we have guitars, we have even some drums, you know. It's not like in Sam, it's drums. This time I would say it's synths. I have a guest composer.
Really?
Yeah.
Who is this?
It's Chris Christodoulou. He's a Greek composer who did Risk of Rain.
Right.
And he's an amazing person and amazingly talented composer. I will guest compose a song for Chris' latest project, and he's doing the Risk of Rain Returns, and he will do a song for the Talos Principle 2.
What other collaborations have you got up your sleeve?
I never hired a singer. This is going to be the first time for me, and an amazing German singer called Julie Elven will perform one of the songs in Talos. Should be an amazing experience. She's very talented, has a beautiful voice.
So what kind of styles are we covering?
Actually, many. We are taking you on the four sides of the world, you know, in this new experience called Talos 2. Each side of the world, like east, west, north, you know, has its own instrumentation. I mean, they all share something. You can actually notice it's Talos, you know, but there are some specific instruments that are used only for certain regions.
You do all the sound on Talos 2 as well?
Yeah. It's all sound design. It's music and sound.
I didn't realize that. I don't know who I thought did it, but I didn't realize you were doing all of that as well.
I did all the sound on Sam 4 as well.
Talos 2 team photo. Everybody say, algorithm!
Algorithm!
Talos Principle 2, I don't think you intended that it would be quite on the scale that it is now?
It's like when you're trying to cook the frog, you know, it doesn't know until it's, you know, there is no single moment, it's just gradually.
It's a good metaphor. Happens.
Well, I'm not very skillful at that, to be honest. I have to work on that, but I learned my lessons. The players will enjoy it for sure, right? But the production side of things, it is really a big game.
So everything is up to 11. Everything is so amplified this time. It's like a full-blown experience. Like Talos 1 was just a trailer. It will feel like that. And here comes Talos 2. It's going to be large, big, bold, loud, brash. It's going to be, on the other hand, humble, small, intimate. You know, it's going to make you think. It's going to make you angry when you can't solve the puzzle. Ooh, the puzzles. I love the puzzles.
Nervous though about how it's going to be received by the players?
No, I'm very confident Good. About it, so maybe that's my famous last words, but we will see.
I think Talos 2 is going to be better than Talos 1. We have simultaneously release on all platforms, which also benefits of Unreal.
Yeah.
So that's something that we didn't have on Talos 1.
Yeah.
So that's a big push.
We learned a lot, very excited about the tech, and it gives me great confidence to see what the team is capable of in such a short time with so many new things going around.
It's very ambitious. It's a bit more ambitious than I personally thought it would be. The ideas that are in there and the way that they are told, I'm very happy.
It seems like one continuous thing, not something that we attached later on to the first one. It seems like this is one story. And I think that's a pretty good sign. It feels meaningful to me. It feels like it has real heart.
It's been 9 years. I'm scared. You know, everything has changed. The world has changed. The players' habits have changed. You know, the amount of games that's coming out, this yeah. also has changed. You know, everything is up to 11 now, you know. So we will do the best we can, you know, to make the best game. And I think the game is really, the puzzle is amazing. The story is thought-provoking. It will make you think, you know. That's the story of Talos 1 made people think. That's one of its strongest assets, you know, and this one will make people think harder. It will bring up new questions. It will maybe provide some answers.
We hope it's beautiful on audio-visual side of things, and that it, you know, challenges you mentally, intellectually, right? And that it brings very special writing and a story that is, yeah, that's the goal. That was our aim.